Students, we are connecting two resistors in series, and as you are connecting potential difference V for these two resistors which are in series, there will be some voltage dropped across AB, that is V1, and across BC there is some voltage dropped, that is V2. Already we have learnt equivalent resistance for connected in series resistors, so R equivalent can be written as R1 plus R2, right? And we also know that V is equal to V1 plus V2. V is equal to V1 plus V2, so that I can write V1 is equal to V minus V2, right? V1 is equal to V minus, what is V2? V2 can be written as I into R2. Okay. This is V1 is equal to V minus I R2, where R2 is the resistance. Let me take this as equation number 1. But what is I? I is equal to V divided by R equivalent. This is V divided by R1 plus R2. Let me take this as equation number 2. Now from this, I can write, take this equation 2 and substitute in equation 1. V1 is equal to V minus, what is I? I is equal to V divided by R1 plus R2 into R2. From here you can take V common. V1 is equal to V, if I take it common, it is 1 minus R2 divided by R1 plus R2. This is V into R1 plus R2 minus R2 divided by R1 plus R2. R2 and R2 gets cancelled. This is R divided by R1 plus R2 into V is equal to V1. This is one of the important equations. So as I already told you, there will be some voltage dropped across this first resistor. Voltage dropped across this first resistor can be calculated directly if you know what is the total voltage provided over there. So it is V1 equal to R1 divided by R1 plus R2 into V. Simultaneously, you can write V2 is equal to R2 divided by R1 plus R2 into V. This is equation to find out voltage V2. So V1 and V2 are the voltages dropped across these resistors. So you can find out voltages dropped across those resistors, V1 and V2, directly by using this relation, right? This is one of the important formulas you need to remember so that you can solve problems easily. Students, already we have learnt how resistors will be connected in series and how they will be connected in parallel. So if there are multiple paths for the current passing through, then the combination is said to be as parallel combination. Resistors are said to be connected in parallel. Now let us see, in this case, you have battery of potential V. Voltage of the battery is being given. This is positive terminal of the battery and this is negative terminal of the battery. As you are connecting resistors R1, R2, R3 in such a way, when current comes over here, it is divided into three parts, I1, I2 and I3. Therefore, this combination is said to be parallel combination. Resistors are said to be combined in parallel. The equivalent circuit of this can be simply drawn like this. You can connect one battery. If you combine all the three resistors, you will be getting only one resistance, that I am considering it as R equivalent, and total voltage supplied here will be V. Therefore, I can write current I is equal to V divided by R equivalent. This is current in the circuit. Likewise, when you are connecting resistors in parallel, the current which comes over here, that current is being divided into three parts. Therefore, current entering to this point is equal to current leaving at this point. And this point is said to be as node. Okay. So what is node? node is the point in the circuit where more than two wires meet. So here there are more than two wires meeting, therefore you can call that as a node, and at that particular nodal point current gets divided. At node current divides, and that current entering is equal to current leaving. So what is current entering here? It is I. And how much is current leaving here? From the first path it is I1, from the second path it is I2, from the third path it is I3. Let me take this as equation number 1. So I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3, right? Now if you observe carefully, this resistor R1 is connected to these two ends, right? Okay, resistor R1 is in between P and Q, R2 is also in between P and Q, and R3 is also in between P and Q. And where is this P connected? P is connected to positive of the battery and Q is connected to negative of the battery. Therefore, at this point, the voltage is treated to be as V, which is voltage of the battery. And at this point, you can treat it as 0 because it is connected to negative terminal. As the battery is offering voltage V, and it should be across this positive terminal, so that is plus V I am taking. So R1 is connected between V and 0. R2 is connected between V and 0. R3 is also connected in between V and 0. Therefore, you can write when resistors are connected in parallel, voltage across them is same. Therefore, voltage across first resistor, voltage across second resistor, voltage across third resistor will be same. V1 is equal to V2 is equal to V3 is equal to V. Total voltage will be remain same. But what about the current? Current is being divided. Therefore, second point which you need to learn is current across the resistors is different. In the figure itself, you can see current in the first resistor is I1. Current in the second resistor is I2. Current in the third resistor is I3. Therefore, here you can write current in the first resistor I1 is equal to what is voltage supplied for this resistance R1, that is V. And what is its resistance? R1. Therefore, I can write I1 is equal to V by R1. I2 is equal to V by R2. I3 is equal to V by R3. I1, I2, I3 are the currents in the circuit. Now, so first step is that we are telling voltage across all the resistors are equal. And in the second step, we are deciding that current in the resistors are not equal. We are writing individual equations for currents, right? Now, as we know in equation 1, I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. What is I? I is already learned here. I is equal to V divided by R equivalent. That is equal to, what is I1? I1 is V divided by R1 plus V divided by R2 plus V divided by R3. Because I1, I2, I3, we have already got it as V by R1, V by R2, V by R3. Just substituting here. V, you can take it common in the numerator in right hand side. So you can cancel that V over there. So finally you can write 1 by R equivalent is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. This is the effective resistance of the resistors combined in parallel. So what is your confirmation? You can confirm in this. Whenever resistors are connected in parallel, what would happen? R equivalent in parallel is, or you can write it as, reciprocal of R equivalent in parallel combination. Reciprocal of R equivalent is equal to sum of reciprocal of individual resistors. So that is 1 by R equivalent is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. This is how, when resistors are connected in parallel, their reciprocals are added in order to get reciprocal of the equivalent resistance. Students, let us take two resistors, R1 and R2, which are connected in parallel as shown in this figure. The voltage which is provided here for resistance R1 and R2 is V, because across this positive terminal, one end of R1 is connected to V, other end is connected to zero. Similarly for R2 also, one end is connected to V and the other end is connected to zero. R1 and R2 have same voltage difference, that is V. Right? So V1, voltage across the first resistor, is equal to voltage across the second resistor, is equal to V. That we have already learned. Now I want to find out individual currents I1 and I2. So in order to find out individual currents I1 and I2, as we know that I is equal to I1 plus I2, where I value you already know, I want to find out equation for I1. What I do, I1 is equal to I minus I2. Now, how do you write I2? Let me take this as equation number one. I2 can be written as I2 is equal to V divided by R2. I2 is equal to V divided by R2. But what is V? V is equal to I into R equivalent divided by R2. Take this as equation number two. See, we already know that V is equal to IR. Here we are finding total voltage of these two resistors, so that I can write it as IREQ divided by R2. Now take this and substitute in this equation one. I1 is equal to I minus of IR equivalent divided by R2, because I2 I am writing it as IR equivalent by R2. Okay. Take this as equation number three. Now, as we know, equivalent resistance of the two resistors which are connected in parallel, you can write it as 1 by R1. You can write equivalent resistance of resistance as 1 by R equivalent is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. 1 by R equivalent is equal to R2 plus R1 divided by R1 R2. From here, R equivalent is written as R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Take this as equation number 4. Take this 4 and substitute in equation 3. What do you get? Using 4 in 3, you can take this R equivalent and substitute here. I1 is equal to I can take it common. It is 1 minus, what is R equivalent? R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2 into R2. Check it up. R equivalent in equation 3, R equivalent is replaced with R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Denominator R2 is there as it is. This R2 and R2 gets cancelled. I1 is equal to I into R1 plus R2 minus R1 divided by R1 plus R2, and that gives you finally equation I1 is equal to I into this plus R1 minus R1 gets cancelled. What is left over with? R2 R1 plus R2. So remember, when you want to find out current I1, take its opposite resistor. Opposite resistor is R2 in the numerator divided by sum of those resistors. Similarly, you can write I2 is equal to net current I R1 divided by R1 plus R2. This is how you can find out individual currents in the resistors. Clear? I1 and I2 are the individual currents in the circuits. However, voltage across one, first one and the second one will be remain same. Currents is I into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. If it is I2 current in numerator, you should take it as R1, right? Likewise, in case of voltages in series we got voltages. How do you write voltage V1? V1 is equal to V into R1 divided by R1 plus R2. Likewise, V2 is equal to V into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. This is about voltages which we have got in series combination. In series combination, voltages get divided. That is the reason why we are writing directly equations for voltage V1 and V2. Here I1 is equal to I2. In parallel combination, voltages remain same. V1 is equal to V2, but currents get divided. Equation for currents of the individual resistors can be directly written as I into R2 by R1 plus R2. Students, we have one problem. This problem is based on series combination because all the resistors are connected in series. Check it up. R1, R2, R3. All the three resistors are connected in series because there is only one path for the current to flow. Okay. So if 9 volt battery is connected here, for this 9 volt battery will provide some current, and that current, let me consider it as I. That current will be flowing through this resistor R1. Same current will be flowing through this resistor R2. Same current will be flowing through this resistor R3. Right? So as the circuit which is being given, it is in series combination. First note which you should write is, in series combination, I is equal to constant, V gets divided. Right? Current in the circuit is constant. Current in all these resistors is constant, but voltage gets divided. Voltage across the first resistor become V1. Voltage across second resistor become V2. Voltage across third resistor become V3. Right? Now, in the question, what you are supposed to find? Find equivalent resistance and current in the circuit. Now, whenever you want to find out equivalent resistance, as it is series combination, what is the effective equivalent resistance? It is R1 plus R2 plus R3. R equivalent will be equal to, what is R1? 3 kilo ohm plus 10 kilo ohm plus third resistor 5 kilo ohm. This is equal to 10 plus 5, 15 plus 3, 18 kilo ohm is R equivalent. This is R equivalent. I can redraw this circuit in this way. All the resistors can be simply combined with one battery. This is R equivalent, which is equal to 18 kilo ohm. Voltage is 9 volt. 9 volt you are providing to this equivalent resistance. For all these three resistors, you are combinedly providing 9 volt. So equivalent resistance we have calculated. Next, you should find out what is current in the circuit. Now, in order to find out current, we have relation. I is equal to V divided by R equivalent. What is V given? 9 volt divided by, what is R equivalent? 18 kilo ohm. 9 to 18, I is equal to 1 divided by 2 into what is kilo? Kilo is written as 10 power 3 volt per ampere. So I is equal to what is 1 by 2? 0.5 into 10 power minus 3 volt per ohm is equal to ampere. Therefore, current in the circuit is 0.5 milli ampere. That is current in the circuit. See, looking to the circuit, students, here you should find out equivalent resistance and current. But in this circuit, some resistors are connected in parallel and the other resistors are connected in series. Let me first name those resistors. I'll name this as R1, R2, R3 and R4. These are four different resistors which we have. R3 and R4 are being connected with end to end. Therefore, suppose if here voltage is V and here voltage is 0, like I'm imagining it is not always V and 0, but for our simplicity, we are considering it as V and 0. If this voltage is V and here I'm considering it as 0, R3 is connected between V and 0, R4 is also connected between V and 0, right? Similarly, if you are coming across current in these resistors, R1 and R2, there is only one path for current across this R1 and R2. In R1, current is I, and in R2 also current is I. But coming to this point, current get divided into two parts because there is one node here. Some part enter into this. Let me consider it as I1. Some part enter into this. Let me consider it as I2. Okay. So I1 and I2 are the individual currents. Let me take, like, I don't want to miss the order. For R3, I'll take it as I1. For R4, I'll take it as I2. That's not big deal and it's not an issue also. So I is current in the two resistors, R1 and R2. After coming here, it get divided into two parts. Some part goes to R3, some part goes to R4. So clearly from looking to the circuit, you can tell that R1 and R2 are in series. R3 and R4 are connected in parallel. So R1 and R2 are in series, R3 and R4 are connected in parallel. So first I'll write down equivalent resistance in series. How do you write equivalent resistance in series? It is R1 plus R2, that is R1 is 100 ohm plus 400, which is equal to 500 ohm. That is resistance because of this series combinations. Next, coming to R3 and R4, we have resistance in parallel, which is R3 R4 divided by R3 plus R4. That is parallel combination formula. What is R3? 100 into 200 divided by 100 plus 200, that is 300. This zeros gets cancelled. And this is equal to 200 divided by 3 ohm. Now, series combination resistance is 500 ohm. Parallel combination resistance is 200 by 3 ohm. Now, what I'll do, I'll redraw the circuit. I'll redraw this circuit like this. Overall, it is connected to a battery of 6 voltage. What about this? It is RS, which is equal to 500 ohm. And this is RP, which is equal to 200 divided by 3 ohm. Check it up. This total part is becoming now 200 by 3 ohm. And this total part is now becoming 500 ohm. So I have redrawn the circuit like this. 500 ohm and 200. Now how are these RS and RP connected? RS and RP are in series. So they are in series. So I can write down equivalent resistance as 500 plus 200 divided by 3 ohm, which is equal to 3515 plus 200 divided by 3. It is 1700 divided by 3 ohm. This is R equivalent. Equivalent resistance, we have got it as 1700 divided by 3 ohm. So first part is completed. Equivalent resistance we have already calculated. Next, you should calculate current in the circuit. So in order to find out current in the circuit, we have basic relation I is equal to V divided by R equivalent. What is voltage provided in this bat, in this 6 volt divided by, what is equivalent resistance? 1700 divided by 3, which gives you 326, that is 2 divided by 1700. This is equal to 2 by 17 into, this 2 zeros goes to numerator, 10 power minus 2. It is 0.0, 17 ones, 17 remained is 3, point already here, so it is 0. 17 once again 17 remained is 13, so on. So nearly it will be I is equal to 0.12. I am rounding off, 0.12 into 10 power minus 2 ampere, or you can write it as I is equal to 0.012 into 10 power minus 3 ampere. So this gives you simply I is equal to 0.012 milliampere. Right? This is the net current in the circuit.